Good morning Luca, we are in San Velomiles in Sardinia, Italy, for to go up to visit
The
the
bell
bell
tower.
tower.
I understand is the tallest tower in the area of the churches in the area, so it must be a nice panorama. And I understand that the bell is just being redone, and I'm looking forward to the opportunities. I've been here for so many years, never had the chance to visit it. So today is a beautiful day, peaceful Sunday morning, and there will be a great opportunity to visit. And the bell tower near to this church, which is holding the Madonna di Spagna. In fact, there is a
Sì. Are you ready to go up 40 meters?
40
40.
meters, absolutely. Ready to
Let's
go.
go, vamos.
Let's go.
Allora, bene. Ecco, com'è stata la salita e la visita? Bene?
Bello, bello,
Tutto
bellissimo.
bello, bellissimo. Ciao.
Ciao.
Allora, prego. Let's go.
We start climbing.
Ok,
slowly because
now it's the darkness, but we can. We
No,
can.
no rush, just one step at a
Sì,
time.
first 25 degrees, no, 25 gradini,
Steps.
steps. Oh.
Okay, we have
Ok,
25,
now
so no big deal.
we have light,
Yeah.
natural light, ok?
Oh, it's
First time to
very
go
cool.
up.
For me, it's really the first time. But I believe that before, in the past, the church was not such a great shape, so probably this opportunity was not available. And during summer also is very hot. So,
Ecco,
but
this bell tower is the second bell tower for high in the Diocese of Oristano because the bell tower of Oristano is 41 meters in picco.
Okay, so this one is 40, the tallest is 41.
Ecco, questi fori, sai che cosa erano?
No.
Nella costruzione esterna mettevano l'impalcatura, per cui appunto si dovevano appoggiare in modo da tenere tutto
Struttura.
attorno, vedi? Allora diciamolo questo perché siamo nel 1700 quando viene costruita e quindi per salire man mano l'impalcatura aveva
Aveva questi.
dei
Ok.
sostegni interni.
So, this tower has been built in 1700. It's clearly, and you can see the sign where the external structure to allow the tower to be built was based on. So, you have the square holes
Luca,
where the
Luca.
wood was were put in place to allow people to climb, and the big. This is local material in called is limestone, I
Sì,
believe, and is local, so
trachite, trachite
trachyte.
locale. Ecco, da qui abbiamo già una prima visione sul paese. Di fronte a noi il Montiferro. Il Monte Montiferro.
Here we go. Oh, beautiful. Yeah, that is the mountain, and tradition warns that when the mountain is not clear, bad weather comes. But if the mountain is clear, just wait. And the nice weather like today,
Ecco, qua
look at this view.
si vede l'altra parte del paese, Zediani sullo sfondo.
Town of Sediani.
Zediani,
Yeah,
the
on the
village.
way to Oristano.
And Barattili.
And Barattoli. And that's the big construction there is a water tower
Sì,
per
for the
l'acqua.
water, sì, water tower.
Ok.
Ok.
You should check with the local town hall and put during the
Be
quest, you put the name of the town
careful for
somewhere.
the head.
Okay.
Ok. We are arrived 100. 100. Ok.
Hello.
No, no, no. Attenzione, lì no.
Grazie.
Luca, siamo al piano delle campane.
Ecco. A beautiful view all around, and you can see the I was looking at where the Tirso, the dam that we were the other day, was. So where the river comes through and is providing the water to all this beautiful green region. Now we are on the top, almost at the top of the bell tower with the three old bells plus an electronic one which you just mounted, which provide beautiful sounds in the morning at 8 o'clock and 8 o'clock, a che ora?
12.
Alle 8, at 8, 12 every day.
Sì. E 8 p.m. 8 a.m. E questa è la campana che ha destato molta curiosità, ne ha parlato anche il telegiornale della Sardegna Vidiolina, è del 1722 e raffigura la Madonna di Bonaria, che sarebbe lei con una barca sulla mano destra. E poi il fondatore dei mercedari, San Pietro Nolasco. Come mai è qui e invece dovrebbe essere appunto a Bonaria, la Basilica di Bonaria a Cagliari? Questo è un grande mistero che stiamo cercando di risolvere.
Ecco. So this is a bell which should not be here, should be in Cagliari, a Madonna di Bonaria, but for some reason excuse me. It was brought here and it was mounted here and stays here. It's one of the bell electronically, you know, with the mechanical actuator where is that rings every day for the pleasure of San Vero. It looks like a lot of people, since the bell has been upgraded, they are very happy to have the sound of the bells in town, which is I remember since I was a kid in other places was really a very pleasant sound.
C'è scritto il nome del fondatore dei mercenari, San Pietro Nolasco.
San Pietro Nolasco was the founder of the mercenari.
Mercedari, sì.
Mercedari. Mercedari, which is
erano quelli che riscattavano i prigionieri nei paesi musulmani.
Ah, ok. I mercedari nei secoli were scorsi. The group that was in charge of exchange prisoners with the in some Muslim countries. So that that was in the honor of the saint representing that group. And again, it was supposed to be in a church in Cagliari, which is way south, is about an hour and a half drive from here, but it ended up here, so it became a property of San Vero, and there's been
a big question of why this bell is here.
Nobody knows.
Not why in Cagliari. I don't know.
Nobody knows, but you just keep it and you use it, right?
It's beautiful. E quindi adesso sarà oggetto di investigazione. Bene, qua vedi, abbiamo i nomi delle persone che hanno contribuito a realizzare la torre. Guida, Cavallazzi e poi altri qua.
Totaro.
Sì, I think. Totaro e poi anche questo. Ecco, quest'altro nome qua che si legge a malapena, ma potrebbe... essere un cristo, sì. Ecco.
And the other thing is that very not very well known is that just south of here it was during the Second World War it was also an airfield. In fact, you can see the opening right after these trees and it was an airfield, an aviation airfield that
sì, ecco.
Was not very well known but it was bombed. They found it. It was bombed, putting a risk the town of San Vero. But fortunately, the church survived.
Allora, e poi di fronte a noi il paese di Milis e tutto il Montiferru e Seneghe là sopra.
So this is Montiferru. Say that town mid coast is Seneghe. The next village is Milis. And as you see, this is the very beginning of the Campidano.
Ecco, and, lì vediamo Narbolia là in fondo. Narbolia.
That's on the extreme side, there is Narbolia, which is a town which was founded, my understanding, from Turkish, from a Turkish crew of a ship that crashed on the shores, and they had no way to sail again, so they came inland and they founded a new village. And in fact, is, you know, the people you see is different because they have such a different origin. Sardinia is famous to be more on this Spaniard side on the north, while the south, it was open to the Mediterranean, so a lot of many cultures went through. And in fact, the sea was a big danger in the past, in the Middle Ages. So a lot of villages have been created inland in such a way they were protected by the distance from being attacked.
Lì sopra si continua e c'è la zona dell'orologio, perché appunto era manuale, quindi c'era la manovella, qualcuno che ogni giorno doveva dare la corda. E poi si arriva fino alla cipolla.
So there is a steeper stairs to go up where there was where there is the clock, which once was manual, so somebody had to go up every day and charge the spring to make it work. And going further up, there is, you can go into the big onion shape, the top of the tower. But again, the stairs are very steep, and there is no end rail to be used. So I'm not going further up. But I believe that it must be a great place to visit. So the church, the bell tower is open every Sunday between 9:15 to 10:15 for visit, and everybody's welcome to see it.
In June. In May, now only in May.
Only May.
In summertime
it's different. Okay, so but check out with the church, and they will they can let you know when it's open to be visited. So I'm lucky to be here in the month of May, which is so beautiful and green and lush.
Thank you, Luca.
It's been a pleasure these few days, just few days in San Vero. I just got reacquainted with my ancestors, with the village that where my grandfather was born, and see friends. I've been up for many years, and so nice, and everybody so welcome. Thank you very much, Don Ignazio. You've been really a big promoter of this area with your pastorale. Sì. And I hope that the tradition will go on for this and other areas.
È davvero un autore portoghese dice, ho visitato molte chiese in Portogallo, sta parlando di 70 anni fa, peccato che erano quasi tutte chiuse, quindi stiamo cercando di tenerle aperte, perché la Chiesa dice a tutti tantissimo di una comunità, ecco.
Esatto. Quindi a priest from Portugal said the one that in the past he visited his own country, and he was so disappointed that most of the churches were closed. So now the effort is to make them open in such a way that welcomes the community, make it be more part of the entire community. So nice. Thank you again for this, and I'm looking forward to bring friends here to see it firsthand. And please visit Sardinia.
Visit Sardinia, visit San Vero Milis.
Visit San Vero Milis di Oristano, which is not just the beautiful beaches, but also the beautiful inland with all the tradition. The old churches, the bell towers, the food. So many reasons to come and visit. The agriturismo is very well developed, so you won't have any problem finding a great place to stay as well.